we're with Revolution Magazine. We're online magazine, and we guys love your shit. The thing I wanted to ask you was, on this tour, this is like the third city, right?
Yes.
So now from here you go where, to Ohio?
Ohio, yeah, Cleveland.
And then after that, where do you end up?
Pittsburgh.
Yeah, we're doing like the whole East Coast, our, you know, back to New York, everywhere. And then we go from there to, we're playing the, what is it, the Rockin' America Festival, which is our second American festival ever, so.
I know, I wish you guys were on the M3 Festival here.
Yeah.
I don't know if you heard about
that,
but
we did.
You're doing it down there, I guess, with the Scorpions
right.
and Twisted
exactly.
and Rat and everybody. And Rat and Twisted played last year here for that festival.
Mm-hmm.
This year it's like the Scorpions and LA Guns, so it's some of the same bands.
Yeah.
It would have been great to see you guys do that.
To Europe to play the Bakken Festival, which is like 100,000 people. It's got, Motley Crue, Alice Cooper, Iron Maiden,
nice.
Wasp, I mean everybody. So
that's my dream vacation, trust me, man.
And it's the beginning of our European tour, which we headline all through Europe. And then Japan, South America, and just goes on.
Great. How was last night's show?
Last night was great. I mean, you know, it's Jersey, you know? I mean, you play Jersey and it's just, it always is pretty much the same.
Cool.
So it was great. It was a great show.
First night was good in New Hampshire?
First night was good, yeah. We were way up in the mountains. We saw a bear and a moose.
And a deer.
it was a great show. It was really, really crazy and wild. And, you know, like I said, we're way up at the top of some mountain somewhere. But it was fun.
Awesome.
You know, you get to play all these different places all over the world. So it's you never know where you're going to go.
Very cool. How's it different touring now as opposed to being in the 80s time frame?
I think there's more of a relaxed thing now. Our show is just as big and there's still as complex, but it's still it's a lot more fun now. You know, we used to be a little bit more under pressure, but, you know, before you're trying to make, trying to put this, you know, show together every night and make sure that it's everything you want it to be. And now, it's automatic, you know. Our show is, we've worked on the show and honed it down over the last 3 or 4 years, and now it's in a good place where it's really working every night. So.
Great. My take on your band, because I heard you talking earlier, I think you're more like Iron Maiden meets Alice Cooper, but that's just me. Would you say that's a good assessment of it? I mean, even though there's a mix of, you know, you kind of have some high throw Halford screaming going on, but I kind of look at the theatrical side of you more like Alice, even though I think probably we have something in common being the first Kiss show. I was 11 in 75, and I saw my first Kiss show, and everybody stood up, and I couldn't see shit, and I ran to the front row.
I was in the lows, and I was 13.
And I mean, it was probably the greatest experience of my life. I was like, I have to play guitar, and that's it, or I got to be in a band of doing something.
It was life-changing. You know,
absolutely.
It had that impact.
Appointment with Death's been out for a while, but you're still gaining a ton of fans right now, which is very cool.
People are just discovering it, like we released it last week.
Right. Which is very cool.
It's good for us, you know, because we made that record to be heard, so we want people to eventually find it somewhere, because there wasn't a lot of promotion for it, you know. This tour is like almost the biggest thing that we've done for it. You know, we've been touring for the last few years, but this world tour that we're about to embark on, you know, the Appointment with Death album is really the theme of the whole. You know, I usually do a lot of research on everything that I do, but I didn't do it. I just liked the name, you know. I figured it was perfect for my theme.
So you have two new guitarists with this tour, and even though Ira played on the album, what's Darren and Chris's?
It's Chris Sanders and Dario Lorena.
Right.
And both of them are just unbelievable. The combination between the two is just, we have never had that. We never had that kind of chemistry. You know?
So is that going to be the next album featuring those guys?
You know, they're definitely going to be, we'll see what happens. You know, we decided to take the rest of the year and play.
Okay.
And next year, beginning of the year, we'll start working on stuff and see where it takes us.
Were you a big fan of Ronnie?
And big fan.
Did you do any shows with him over the years?
We did festivals with him, and he was always just, I mean, we would play our show, and then as soon as we're done, we'd do interviews and whatever, and we'd run out and have to make sure that there was time to watch the, you know.
Exactly.
We'd always find ourselves in the audience just going, yeah, you know, he was always just spot on. And recently, when Heaven and Hell came through LA, I was right on stage, and
nice.
I got that close, and I just was just listening to the monitor mix. Just so powerful to me.
And then you had back on Menace, you had Alex, and he passed away.
Alex and Corey.
And Corey.
Both
recently.
On the Master of Skies tour.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, Alex was on the Master of Skies tour, and he did the Menace record, and that Murder Smell World Show record. And yeah, it's just amazing that two guitar players that were playing together at the same time.
But see, that got to freak you out that they
it does
died
freak,
of
you know,
similar circumstances.
In the same kind of car, it was a Ford Explorer, so it's like. It is. It's just.
That's got to be surreal to a point, you know, where you're like, what the hell's going on right here? Kind of like one of the lyrics in your song.
I know. That's why I don't question it.
Exactly.
But we have a drink to Alex and Corey every night.
Very good.
So they'll always be remembered, and they'll always be part of what we've done.
They're both great players. I saw both of them do tours with you. And you're writing a lot of this stuff yourself, so you're like coming up with the guitar parts and stuff like that, or the main riff of stuff.
Well,
in some cases,
and Master of Skies and Deal with the Devil, yes. The Appointment with Death record, we did half of it as a band, and then the other half, I had some songs that I had written and we brought in, and Joey and Martin and I kind of mixed and matched, and we got George Lynch to come in and play. We got Corey from Trivium,
yep.
Dave Menichetti from YNT.
Love him.
And, you know, so we brought some different guitar players to bring some other flavors into the...
But were they, like, assisting in the writing process?
No.
Or did you
no,
just have stuff mapped out for them?
Yeah. Like, that whole part for Dave Menichetti, I know his style, so I kind of wrote that rhythm based on that. And I wanted him to... If we couldn't get him to do it, then it was going to be someone that was going to do an impression of Dave Menichetti. But we actually could get Dave Menichetti
very
to do
cool.
it, so it worked out great. He just did an amazing solo on it.
Very cool. As soon as you put the first video out, I was just like, holy crap. Like, they're back and huge. So, I mean, the videos, definitely production-wise and editing, are just out there compared to everybody else. It's like full-on action, multi-cameras rolling all over the place. I mean, you're just beating the shit out of the drums back here. Joey's back here, like, sitting. I mean, as soon as I saw the video, I was just like, I was like speechless. I'm like sitting there going, oh my God, I can't believe I'm watching this. Like, you know, cameras like stuttering and guitars going up and you're beating the hell out of shit. And I'm just like, wow, this is going to be it.
It's
like storm the world again, you know,
right.
Like it's 1984.
That's right. People love the new songs. We've got, you know, a few of the new songs on the show, and everyone's loving the new stuff. As well, it's kind of accepted, it's mutually accepted with the classic material.
Yeah.
So the whole show kind of, it's seamless.
It's great. Well, it was great meeting you. Appreciate the time you guys gave us to have our Revolution here.
Thanks.
And
glad to be part of it.
Go kill them on stage. Revolution Magazine, Dominic with Lizzy Borden.
Yeah.
Joey Scott. See ya.
LizzyBorden.com.